In today's video, I want to show you 5 simple steps to an organized and clean email inbox in the most efficient way. So, what's the first step and what's the best way to keep your inbox clean? I know personally when it comes to my inbox, when it gets cluttered, I really lose productivity and I typically from time to time miss an important email. So I've really made it a habit, at least in the last few years, to really keep my inbox clean. And I'm going to show you with my actual Gmail account, but the same rules actually apply to other email providers. But I'll show you natively inside of Gmail, and then I'll show you a tool here that will make the whole process a lot faster and easier too. The first step is bulk removing emails. Now, we're going to get rid of a ton of unwanted emails this way. So this is really the first step that you should do. And with Gmail and pretty much all other mail providers, the process is typically a bit time consuming. But all you really have to do is go through your inbox and click the check mark here, and you could do it per page and then press delete. So once everything is selected and you press delete, it will delete all the emails that you see on that page. But to speed up the process, let me show you another tool called clean email. So the first thing you want to do is you want to go to clean email, which I'll link below. And here you want to sign in with your Gmail email account. Now this will land you on the clean email home screen. When you're exploring your inbox with clean email, and this one is really, really handy, your messages are grouped already by senders and email addresses. This is totally by default, which makes it really easy to apply any action to that group of emails very quickly. For example, I could just press the trash icon right here and get rid of 18 emails just like that. But all in all, clean email gives you a ton of different tools to sort, to group and to filter your email messages. They have smart folders, for example. They have something called frequently used filter options for quick access and other options above the search bar. This way you won't have a bunch of emails that you already took care of just sitting in your inbox. Step two is all about unsubscribing from promotional marketing emails, newsletters, things that you just don't want anymore appearing in your inbox. Now, I usually recommend unsubscribing from as many marketing emails as you can that you just no longer need, right? This could be just things that you're getting, like a Black Friday sale that you signed up for last year and they keep sending in promotional emails. And you could obviously do this inside of Gmail. You simply click on the email inside of Gmail, find the unsubscribe link at the bottom of the email and click it and then get unsubscribed that way. And for some emails inside of Gmail, you may see an unsubscribe right here, so you don't have to scroll all the way to the bottom. You could unsubscribe just by clicking this and unsubscribing from that email. But the problem is a lot of marketers either don't have an unsubscribe link or they really make it hard to find. But this is another reason clean email is something that I recommend, is because it just makes it a lot easier. You just click one thing and it sends an unsubscribe request on your behalf, and it blocks that sender if they don't respect that request. So this is really important for emails that just don't have a simple unsubscribe. So when that happens, as a result, you basically get unsubscribed from the unwanted email list, even if they don't have an unsubscribe link. This point is really important, so I have a dedicated video in the description below all about unsubscribing from unwanted emails. Step three is to continue to keep your inbox clean and organized, because it's just not enough to declutter your inbox one time. I wish it was like that, but emails are going to come through and your inbox is going to get filled up again. So you do have to do this regularly. And I know the process could be kind of tiresome if you just kind of repeat that process that I've gone through, but there are some things to make this process a lot more automated. One of the ways to keep your inbox organized inside of Gmail is by using filters. If you click the search option right on top, you could actually create these filters by filling out some of these settings. If it has the word subscription, for example, I could type that here, and then I could create a filter using that option and always choose to skip the inbox here by creating this filter. Now, this is where clean email is a lot easier to use, because it has a lot more options that are not as manual as what you have inside of Gmail. So for example, if you want to archive emails as they get older and deleting those that you just don't want anymore and getting rid of unwanted emails, you could automate a lot of that with auto clean inside of clean email. Basically, clean email's auto clean feature helps you automate a bunch of the email tasks, routine tasks that you continue to do over and over again. And this way your inbox gets cleaned and organized automatically. Just to give you an example, you could go to the auto clean feature tab, and here you could create a rule. So for example, you could do mark all incoming emails as spam by a specific email name, right? This way You just don't have to deal with emails coming from that name. This is, again, one of those things where I created a dedicated video all about auto cleaning rules. So you may wanna check that out. Again, link in the description. Number four is all about stopping unwanted emails. Now, this is a bit different than unsubscribing to newsletters. This is where people are sending you basically spam or emails you don't wanna receive from a specific person. You could do this by controlling the delivery of that message based on a sender that's found in your inbox. So inside of Gmail, select an email here. And what you could do here on top is you could press this option, report as spam, and this message will be marked as spam. You could also press the three dots over here and could actually mute this sender as well. And there's one more option that's a little bit hard to find. If you click the email itself, you actually have these three dots over here. This will let you block this email sender. So you have those three different options for reporting spam, muting, and blocking inside of Gmail. Now with clean email, again, this process is a bit easier because you have senders right over here and it's actually organizing everything for you using the senders option. You don't have to actually manually try to find all these emails. So for example, you could block. When you block an unwanted sender, that message basically gets prevented from ever getting to you. That means that the clean email will automatically move that to the trash and it just won't appear in your inbox. This is when you completely want to block an email. But there's a really cool option called mute. Now with mute, it basically mutes the notification of that incoming email. So clean email will continue to deliver the sender's message in the future to your inbox, but it will just get marked as read so you don't get a notification and it won't show up as a new message. Really, really useful. Check out my full video dedicated to muting and blocking email address. Again, I'll link that here. Now, step five is all about stopping all spam. Now, by default, Gmail has a spam folder and some emails by default hit that filter and they will appear in the spam folder. And sometimes you could simply select an email here that is spam and you could report it on top as spam and unsubscribe all in one click. And sometimes with all that, that's still not enough. So clean email introduce a screener option. You want to stop all incoming messages from new senders from reaching your inbox, and you don't want to spend time blocking each new sender individually. So in this case, you activate the screener feature that is going to be really, really useful. This is how it works. The screener will intercept all incoming messages that are from new senders, and it keeps them in an area where they're basically quarantined instead of being delivered to your inbox. Then what you could do is you could review all those messages in clean email and decide if you want to block them or allow them, right? The previous senders go to your inbox. These are new senders. They go to this new area where you can make this decision and keep your inbox clean. Now, if you found any of these five tips useful, and if you want to try out clean email to keep your inbox clean for yourself, I do have a free trial link in the description below this video. I hope you found this video useful. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss the next video. And I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.